You guys, and welcome to my channel. For those of you who are new, today I'm gonna be showing you guys this beautiful makeup routine that I have finally locked down. I am obsessed with this. This has been my go-to summer makeup routine. It lasts all day. It looks so good. You get that coverage, it still looks real nice and smooth. You get that like summer natural-esque bronze look, but you still look real nice and snatched, okay? And that's what we want, okay? The girls have been asking and I have finally produced it for you guys. You guys have been asking and you have finally received. I am so happy to be putting this video out because I am obsessed with this makeup routine just as much as you guys, and I just hope that it gives what you guys have been wanting it to give, okay? Because I feel like it's giving. I feel like it, but it's all about y'all, okay? So just let me know down below in the comments. And yeah, so if you guys want to know how I got this makeup, and if you have been liking any of the makeup looks that I've been wearing in any of my recent videos or on my Insta story, then make sure that you keep watching, because this is exactly how I got it, and I'm gonna show you all the steps, my secrets today. And yeah, so I will see you guys at the end of the video. All right, so we are gonna go ahead and get started. I'm just gonna pin back these pieces. Don't worry about my edges and everything, we're gonna get that together in a minute. Look kind of crazy, but we're gonna come out looking real cute. Okay, so we're gonna start off with the brows. I'm not actually going to show my brow routine or really explain to y'all what I'm doing, because I actually don't even like my brows recently, and I also just want to do an updated brow routine anyway, so I'm just gonna hold off on showing you guys. But once I get them real situated, I'm gonna do a separate video for my brow routine. All right, so the brows are done for the most part, so now we're gonna move on to the next step. We're gonna go ahead and prime. Now this primer duo has been my go-to for a minute now, okay? Y'all have probably seen this way back when, like maybe the beginning of spring, like not even joking. This has been my go-to and I'm obsessed with it for valid reason, okay? These are two e.l.f. products. This is the e.l.f. Poreless Putty and the e.l.f. Blurring Primer Serum. Now I mix the both of these two together and they are literally amazing together. Y'all know I literally like to mix every single product, every step through my makeup routine, so get used to that. It's just me. I never like one or the other. I like that nice medium in between, so you know, that's what we be doing. And I've been loving it since. I love that serum by itself, and it actually feels like I'm doing skincare and primer in the same step, which I think is something that should be married together. Like primer should be very close to skincare, and your skin should always have a nice smooth base, and you should be taking care of your skin before you even think about putting on makeup, you know? We're gonna take a little bit of the both of these. One of these will last you for so long, but I'm putting this all over my face. As you can see, we look a little crazy, but it's okay. And now I'm gonna take two drops of this on either side of the face. I actually think I'm running out. And then we're just gonna smooth this all in. I usually wait until after I do my brows to prime the skin, just because personally I feel like it, I don't know, like the slip that comes with the primer like in my brow area just makes the product apply weird, and I just don't like that. So I always just do my brows first. That's the very first thing that I do, conceal everything, the whole nine, and then I will go in and prime the skin. And y'all, I know it's kind of hard to lean towards oily, more like moisturizing primers and bases when it comes to oily skin. Trust me, I know what you mean. I have crazy oily skin. This duo has worked so well for me. My skin stays moisturized. Like even looking at it, it's real nice and moisturized. It feels real nice and soft, but it's not like oily. It doesn't look like my makeup is going to slip off of my face, you know? So I really like that about this combination. My pores are nice and filled in, and the face is just blurred. Like y'all, for drugstore primers, this duo does it right, okay? I can't even explain it any better than that. Moving on, we're going to go ahead ahead and start concealing. So I conceal in a few different steps. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my Kylie concealer. This is in the shade, I don't know, because it's actually rubbed off. But I'm just gonna take some of this and I'm just going to conceal under my eyes like normal. So I do this. It's like a brightening layer, but it's not really my highlighting layer. I do this to cancel out any darkness on the face, like under eye bags, anything like that, and just get the base. I wouldn't say smooth because it's obviously going to be pretty uneven with a lighter concealer. I don't know how to explain it, but it will all come together. Okay, trust the process. I promise y'all. Y'all have been asking me for the longest time what has been my new go-to makeup routine. And y'all, when I tell y'all, I cannot steer away from this routine because it's literally so good. Now, I've been tweaking a few steps here and there to kind of find that perfect go-to, but for the most part, everything has stayed the same for the past couple of months, and I've been in love with the way that my face turns out. It lasts all day. It looks so good. It looks natural, but you get your glam element in there. Y'all know that's me. I like to have that glam element, that full coverage, you know, full face and makeup. That's just me. I like to be drenched in makeup, and you get all that while still looking real nice and smooth, balanced. You don't look cakey. Everything just looks real nice and put together. So I've been really loving this routine, and y'all have been loving it too, for valid reason. So now I'm just going ahead and blending this in. I'm using the El Hotel face sponge, and I'm just going over everywhere that I put concealer. And y'all, trust me, this layer does not have to be a crazy caked on layer, because we are going to conceal in another layer again. Plus we have a little skin tint that we're going to put on top of everything to really balance everything out. So trust the process. Y'all, if y'all have been loving my current routine, then this is what I do to get it. I mean, you can always tweak steps. If you don't like putting so much concealer, then don't do so, because this is kind of just to cancel everything out and give the face like balance, but not really. I don't really know how to explain it, but you know, this is trust the process, okay? You'll get it once everything is all put together and the face is sitting, and y'all are gonna be like, girl. And I'm gonna be like, I told you. All right, so once that is done, we're gonna move on to the next step, which is my cream contouring and bronzing. So what I've been using to do this step is this e.l.f. foundation palette. It's a cream foundation palette, and I am obsessed with this palette, but I'm not sure if they discontinued it or not. I went to go repurchase a new one because I'm kind of running out, as you guys can see, and I couldn't find it. The only one that I could find was a cream contour palette. So that one is coming in the mail, and I'll try it out and see if that's a dupe for it. If not, I'm gonna have to find you guys a new palette to use. But I just love using this one because it's creamy. It's real nice to work with, especially if you're a beginner when it comes to cream bronzers and contours. Cream is so in right now. This is such an affordable way to get into that, whether you just don't have the money to go out and splurge, or you just want to test it out before you splurge. I'm actually going to blend this shade and this shade, and I'm just going to swirl the two together and make sure my hair is pulled back out of the way. And I'm just going to start carving out where I want to bronze at. Now, this is where things get a little scary, because I'm sure y'all are going to be like, oh my gosh. I go in with a pretty heavy hand, I'm not gonna lie. I love the bronze look, especially right now since it's summer. And trust me, I do not play when it comes to putting on my cream bronzer. Like I said, trust the process. This is exactly what I've been doing in that routine that you guys have been asking me about for so long. So just bear with me, it'll come together. So I'm using this brush. I love this brush for this step. This is the pointed foundation brush by Real Techniques. And I just love this because it's really easy to move around and manipulate, move the product and disperse it perfectly. And it's also easy to blend in this, and I'll show you how I blend everything in just a second. And I know it's gonna get a little crazy, but I'm just gonna take whatever's on the brush, contour my nose. So this doesn't have to be straight or even in any form, kind of just get like the basic mapping out of how you want to contour your nose, and we'll go from there, and I'll show you how to build off that. So we're looking crazy. Bear with me, I promise you it's going to come together. I'm just gonna kind of just start tapping out where I laid out that bronzer. Tapping, that's literally all I'm doing, which is why I go so low with it originally, because I like to blend it upwards so that you get that nice like seamless blend. It looks really good. And so I just kind of tap it all around, and look how fast it's like started to blend out. That's what I love about this product as well. You can, it looks like you just went overboard, but it'll blend blend out literally like butter. It's easy for you to make a mistake and fix it. Like I said, I'm literally just tapping it out and slowly bringing it upwards, and you will see those harsh lines literally fade away. And I kind of like to bring it in on my temples a lot, because I will sometimes just bring it into my eye crease just so that that all meshes together with the nose contour and to the cream bronzer. And it does like this whole like lifting thing, and I love it. And it's like you don't even have to do eyeshadow afterwards, because it's like a natural shadow. Y'all are probably like, girl, you're going in for more? Yes, just a little bit to deepen up some areas. And literally look how easy it starts to blend out with just this one little motion. And then I don't really worry too much about blending this part out now. This will kind of get blended in the later steps. I will just kind of run over it. And the same goes for the nose contour. I'll just kind of run over it a bit, but I don't really worry about blending it too much in this step. And then boom. I know we look crazy, but it's going to come together, I promise. It's just gonna get scarier from here, but again, trust the process, I promise you. I remember when I used to say I hate Shape Tape, like I don't get the hype. Yeah, I've been kind of obsessed with it lately. I don't know what it is, but I'm just taking my Tarte Shape Tape. This is in the shade Tan Deep Sand, and I know y'all are probably like, girl, that shade is a little too light for you. It's going to come together, okay? I'm gonna take this. I'm not gonna take a lot, because a little bit of this product goes a long way. This is the original formula as well, and I'm just gonna put a dot right in the inner corner, dot on the outer corner, and do the same on the other eye. I'm also going to do just a little bit on the nose, so I'm underneath the nose to highlight that area. I'm gonna do a dot on the chin. I'm running out, so we're gonna do a dot on the forehead, and I'm also just gonna lightly start to drag this down the side of my nose just so that we can get that nose contour started and start getting it under control. All right, so once we have laid down that base with our Tarte Shape Tape, I'm gonna go ahead and take that same sponge and just start to blend that concealer out. Pretty self-explanatory. I love this sponge because you can cover a big area in such little time and it still looks really good. And it does a really good job of blending everything together. It does a great balance of picking products up and laying them out. And I think that's a good mix to have with the sponge, especially when you're doing a routine like this. It works very well to get everything real nice and blended. So for this outer area dot, I kind of just focus it literally in that area, and I don't like to bring it too far out, so I'll actually flip my sponge over and start tapping it out with that side so that it just kind of blends into that bronzer rather than creating like a harsh stopping point, and you still get that highlighted look. But since I have a round face as is and pretty wide, I want my face to look shorter, not wider. And if you bring the highlighted points of your face out further by bringing out that concealer more, it's going to elongate your face width-wise a lot more, which I learned the hard way. And I started doing my makeup this way, and it makes a huge difference. I know on other people sometimes it doesn't look like a difference, but try it on yourself and you'll notice it. And look how everything just starts to seamlessly blend here. It's not completely blended, and we're going to get that taken care of in a second, but this is also why I said you don't need to go so super harsh with the concealer with that first layer of concealer that we did, because we went over top of that with another concealer, and now my under eye looks perfectly concealed and it just looks good. Wow, it's so nice to see everything come together in the blend. All of these products literally blend together like butter, and I don't know if you guys can tell, but we're looking good. Like, it's starting to piece together, and I know it may still look a little bit weird to you guys, but to me, since I know the process, I know now this is when it's starting to come together. And you'll see in a second, like I said, everything for this step looks to be real nice and blended. I like to leave the concealer on my nose for a little bit longer, but I'm gonna give you guys a little look at what the face is looking like now. And again, I know this is down pretty low, but we'll get that taken care of in a minute. But this is what we're looking like. So now let's go ahead and move on to the next step. I don't use a foundation. I have been using my Fenty Skin Tint, and this is in the shade 19, I believe. Oh yes, it is 19. And I'm gonna take the same sponge, which I think is another thing to help keep everything consistent. Using the same sponge will help blend all of those different shades together a lot more. And so I'll just kind of take a bit of this and tap it on the face. I'm going to go ahead and hit my neck now as well. Most of the product ends up going on my neck. So now I'm gonna start blending this out. I'm gonna kind of focus it more so here at first to kind of carve out the shape of where I want my bronzer to stop. I know y'all are seeing it now. It's coming together, right? And then we're gonna start taking that up everywhere. to just kind of mesh everything together, even on the forehead and even on the nose. Like that. The framework of your nose contour is already laid out. It's not too harsh. It looks really good. And I'm going to take that same brush. I'm not going to take any more product that we used to bronze with. And I'm actually just going to intensify a few areas. Personally, you do not have to do this if you don't feel it necessary. But personally, I love a bronze face. Like I said before, I'm also just doing those same motions as before as well. So once again, keep everything consistent. Oh, I am obsessed with this face. Now I'm going to kind of clean off my workspace. I have a hard time of cleaning up as I go. So now we're going to go ahead and start getting ready to set. I'm going to take the other side of the sponge again and just start tapping out that concealer again just to make sure that it is intact and ready to be set. So once that's nice and tapped out, we're going to go ahead and start setting. So I have so many setting powders mixed into this. Sorry. I have so many setting powders mixed into this. I can't even tell you every single one, but I know for sure that I have the Makeup Revolution Banana and the Fenty Beauty Banana in here mixed. And I've been loving this powder mixture so much on the face to set my under eyes. And I'm actually going to take a dry Juno & Co. This is the microfiber sponge, and I like to use this. I will get some products on there and I will just start setting in there. I kind of got too much initially, but it'll be fine. I like to start off kind of light and then build it up. It should be okay. And again, don't take your bake out. You want to leave it here so that you don't end up elongating the face. And we're gonna put this everywhere that we would normally set. Love the way that the Fenty setting powder smells. Am I the only one? I can't be the only one. There's no way I'm the only one. I'm gonna take this over my eyelids as well and also use this to kind of reshape the nose. Once we've kind of gotten that laid on, I'm gonna go ahead and just take brush. This is the Real Techniques contour brush, and I'm gonna just use this to press in the most of that powder. Then we're also gonna kind of dust off some, but right now we're really just gonna focus on pressing that in to the skin. And again, don't take that out. You want to leave it focused right here because you don't want to elongate the face. Try to get under that nose crease because a lot of people forget that. Press it in everywhere that we applied powder. All right, so we are going to kind of leave the center of the nose once again. We're going to come back to the powder underneath here, but I'm just going to take basically the remaining of the powder that is left on the sponge and just kind of carve out the shape that I want right here. I don't take a lot. A lot of people mess up and they do a lot. I just take a little bit just to clean it up a bit, and then it won't look so harsh. It'll be easy to blend that out. Now I'm just gonna take a clean fluffy brush and I'm just gonna go over the face and just kind of tap in. This will pick up the remaining powder from under the eyes and drag it over the places like where we cream contoured, and this will just kind of give that a little preset before we start going in with powder bronzers. So once that's done, I'm gonna go in with my all-time favorite powder bronzer at the moment, the Fenty Beauty bronzer, and this is in the shade Mocha Mommy. This is literally beautiful. Like, I can sit here and just look at the shade. I'm gonna take this Sonia Kashuk brush. Oh my gosh, I have powder all over my arm. I'm gonna take this Sonia Kashuk brush. I don't know the name of it at all. There's no labeling on it. I'm just going to once again just tap this product onto the face everywhere that we cream bronzed. Bring it into the hairline so it looks seamless. Do be careful with this product though, because it can and is pretty pigmented, you know, if you know how to use it. I love that warmth that it gives, and it almost like starts to blush your face, your skin for you. And I'm actually going to bring it upward. You don't want to directly go into the products and start doing this, but once you've tapped it out here and you've gotten the majority of the product off, I just like kind of just start going in circular motions and bring it upward. And it kind of like I said, naturally blushes the face because the shade is so warm. It like almost acts as a blush too, and I love it. So pretty. I love it. I'm gonna put this brush down. I'm gonna grab this brush that I got in an Ipsy bag, but it's just like a regular like fluffy eyeshadow brush. I'm gonna go into the same bronzer and I'm just gonna use this to redefine the nose contour and bring that back into brow bone and connecting it into the bronzer. It's all like one endless seamless connect and seamless blend. You don't want to take a lot. It doesn't take a lot at all. Boom. So now I'm just going to go back to that brush and I'm just going to tap everything out one last time. Get it real nice and sophisticated, situated. It looks like it's about to rain. All right, so now that that is done, we're gonna go into my new favorite step. This is a blush. This is the e.l.f. Primer Infused Blush, and this is in the shade Always Rosy. I just ordered the shade Always Spicy because I heard that one is just like gutter, like this but better. I do love this shade, but I'm so excited to dive. I'm pretty sure our power just went out. Okay, that was interesting. Our power went out. I'm gonna go into blush and I'm gonna take this brush that I got for so long ago, literally. I think it's from the dollar store. I love using it for blush because the shape is just perfect. So I'm just gonna dig into, not dig, but tap the products on, and I'm just gonna kind of start here and just kind of tap on some blush and blend it into the bronzer. And that's how you get like that effortless nice blush look, by blending it all together. I think it's pouring. So blush is on and we are loving her. All right, so now that that is done, we're gonna go ahead and highlight. Y'all know I love using my Naked Cosmetics loose pigments to highlight with. So this is in the shade Sierra Nevada 1. I'm using Sierra Nevada 1 today. No, this is Naturally Nude. What am I talking about? And normally I take Sierra Nevada 2, but I actually think I lost it. But I'm just gonna take this brush and I'm just going to tap it where you would normally highlight. Be careful with this product though, because it does go a bit crazy. It is a loose pigment. So kind of tap that on. We're gonna the nose too. I'm gonna take this on the brow bone and take this on the forehead. I'm gonna hit our cupid's bow. I'm gonna take a more precise brush and I'm gonna pop some in my inner corner as well. Oh, so she's coming together and she's looking real cute, y'all. Oh, all right, so the face is pretty much done. I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyes. So all I'm gonna do is some mascara, but I'll actually just go ahead and do that off camera and then come back for the lips. All right, so mascara is on. I haven't really been feeling the lashes lately. I've been wearing my natural lashes with just some mascara, and y'all tell me, I think that they look so good and they have been looking so good recently, but y'all let me know, and let me know if y'all been feeling the same way, because I feel like not very many people are wearing lashes anymore. Either they have lash extensions or like strip lashes just aren't the move anymore. I don't know. Now we're gonna move on to lips. So y'all know I've been doing the same lip combo for literally the longest time. I'm going to take just some brown eyeshadow from a random Morphe palette and line my lips with eyeshadow with a nice precise pencil brush. I believe this is from AOA Studios or Shop Miss A. Love their brushes. If you ever need brushes, go to Shop Miss A because they're $1 a piece and they're actually really good quality. I might actually order some when I get off of this video. Oh my gosh, you're joking. I just got it on my freaking shoes. All right, so now I'm actually just gonna take this lip plumping gloss by e.l.f. and this is in the shade Mocha Twist. I've been feeling the glosses lately. I think because it's summer, it makes sense. Juicy lips, gotta have them popping, and when the sun hits, magnifique. So I'm just gonna take this shade in the center. All right, and the last step is to set the face. So we're gonna take the Fenty Beauty, what is this called? Baby What It Do Setting Spray, and I'm just going to spray it all over the face. All right, so now that makeup is done, I'm gonna go off camera, fix my hair up a bit, and then come back to close out the video. Oh. Not me recording this whole time. All right, so we are back. Hair is kind of fixed up. The curls kind of fell, but I'm trying not to put too much heat on my hair. But the front pieces are still curled, the bangs, okay, period. That's all that matters. We're just wearing a Fashion Nova bodysuit with some matching sweatpants. For jewelry, we just have on my Whistler necklace from my boyfriend, but we do have on some hoops. That's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below and let me know if this was one of the videos that you guys have been waiting for, because I've been waiting to film it, baby. And I'm obsessed with this routine. I feel like it looks so freaking good, okay? I have just been obsessed with this routine. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. Mwah.